From our pollies to our sports stars.
I feel like a tourist. I feel like a tourist. I feel like a tourist.
The amber ale has long been a central part of our national identity. Whether you got it riding or whether you got it sliding. For generations, Aussies have certainly had a thirst for it. So thirsty, in fact, the average Australian will consume 83 litres of beer every year, which gives us the world gold medal for beer drinking. So long as you don't count those pickled Europeans. Makes you proud, doesn't it? But the days of the humble tinny may be numbered. It seems as manscaping becomes more popular, our taste for the working man's beer fades. The big breweries are feeling the pinch, as more and more Aussies are choosing to raise a glass of boutique beer down at the local. So, in this confusing and neatly stubbled world of boutique beers, which one is the pick of the crop?
And the perfect man to answer that question is a man by the name of Brendan Varis. He's the co-owner of Feral Brewing, and it's a boutique beer. And last night it was awarded an award at the Australian International Beer Awards. He joins me now. Good morning, Brendan, and congratulations.
Morning, Andrew. Yeah, thank you. Very humbled by the awards we managed to get last night.
Can you give us some idea of exactly what this competition is about and who you're up against?
Yeah, the Australian International Beer Awards, I think, is the largest or second largest commercial beer competition in the world. And I guess in a nutshell, if you can think of any beer that you've ever bought and tried around the place, then that beer most likely would have been entered and assessed by a team of professional judges here in Melbourne not so long ago.
Well, that's right. There were 52 judges there last night, 1,344 breweries from 41 different countries, and your beer, the Hop Hog Pale Ale, came out on top. What do you think it was that set your beer apart?
Well, the Hop Hog's got a bit of a record in this regard. It's actually the fourth year in a row that it's been fortunate enough or lucky enough to pick up this award. I guess the thing that we think sticks out about it the most is it's just balance. So all the ingredients of the beer, the malt, the hops, the yeast and the water are all in a nice equal balance, which makes for a pleasant and sessionable beer.
Why do you think there's been this increase in people's taste for the boutique beer?
I think it just mimics a lot of what's happening with the way people eat and drink generally. An analogy we often use is the coffee thing where, you know, 10 years ago we were happy to put a spoon of coffee, international roast type coffee, and stir it up and there was your coffee. Whereas these days we know about single blends and the benefits of the espresso machine. I think beer is very much the same. We've gone away from the more bland beer styles. I'm looking for more interesting flavours in beer.
Yeah, I've heard that being mentioned. It's more becoming like, I suppose, the wine culture, where you want to match your beers to certain things that you're drinking, and people have a more, I suppose, sophisticated palate when it comes to that. Do you have any beers coming out that might also be a taste sensation for people?
Yeah, we've got a new interesting beer coming out soon. It goes by the name of Watermelon Warhead. And if people can think of those sour lollies, this is a not very strong beer, only 2.5% alcohol. It's sour and sherbety and tastes just like a watermelon.
Who exactly are you targeting with that beer?
Look, we target anyone that loves beer, and I think there's a time and a place for many different types of beer. That beer is just really refreshing, and it's certainly apt for the climate that we live in the Swan Valley, which is a very hot wine region on the edge of Perth.
Well, Brendan, congratulations again. Enjoy the rest of your day. Enjoy the medal that I know that you have there with you, and we appreciate your time this morning.
Thanks, Andrew.
Fantastic. And those awards will do them the world of good as well. Mm. I'm sure the business will do good. And that's the future of beer. It's the specialist
microbrewing.
Yeah.